Everyone, myself Vivek Kulkarni. Today I'm going to show you the basic parts of the aircraft. So this is an aircraft. This part is known as the radome of the aircraft. And from here, this is also known as the nose section of the aircraft. From nose to tail, this is known as the longitudinal axis of the aircraft. And here there is spit-out tube. Generally it is in blank, spit-out tube. And this is the angle of attack sensor. This is the cockpit where the pilots and co-pilot sits. And generally this is the wing of the aircraft. In the wing also, we should know which is the port area and which is the starboard area. From the pilot's point of view, this side is the port and that side is the starboard. From pilot's point of view, not from your point of view. From pilot's point of view, this is the port and that is the starboard. Now this area, front side of the wing, generally is termed as the leading edge. Front portion of the wing is termed as the leading edge. And back portion of the wing is known as a trailing edge. So this is the leading edge and that is the trailing edge for any aerofoil section. So wing is an any aerofoil section. So this is the leading edge and that is the trailing edge. In the wing, there are generally primary controls, aileron is fitted. Generally this is rolled. From wing span, that is tip to tip, in the lateral axis is known as the wing span. This is known as the lateral axis. From wing tip to wing tip, this is known as the lateral axis. From nose tip to tail tip, it is known as a longitudinal axis, and vertical axis is this one, normal axis. So this is the fuel tank, this is a Learjet aircraft. Now I will show you the ailerons, which is the primary control surface of the aircraft. This is an aileron. This is operated from the cockpit. Suppose this aileron is moving up and aileron is moving down. So this is that which will go into the opposite direction. So this tab is known as a balance tab. So this is automatically operated. This is a balance tab. And this tab is known as a trim tab, which should be operated from the cockpit. And these are the small wedges, which is known as a vortex generator. This is called as a flap. This is called as a flap, which will be coming down. This is the inboard flap. Some of the aircrafts, huge aircraft, there have inboard flap as well as outboard flaps. So this is the flap. In front of flap, there is one panel fitted over the wing. This is known as a spoiler. This is called as a spoiler. These are operated hydraulically over here. This is engine. This is a port side engine. There is also starboard side engine. And tail section. This is known as the empennage section of the aircraft. Empennage. And in the empennage section, there is stabilizers, horizontal stabilizers, and fin area. A horizontal stabilizer and fin area. So, same similar way, on that part of the wing, the same ailerons are fitted. This is rudder, which is operated by foot pedal. This is also primary control surfaces. And above that is elevator, which is also a primary control surface. So aileron, elevator and rudders are the primary control surfaces in the aircraft. Now I'll show you the landing gears. There are, generally this is tricycle landing gear, two main and one nose. So that's why it is known as a tricycle landing gear, two main and one nose. So Airbus 320 is also having the same configuration, two main and one nose. So they are coming under tricycle landing gear. Similar way, here there is one flap and spoiler and also aileron. This aileron, once this aileron is going up, that side aileron will be going down for the rolling action. These are again vortex generators. In this aircraft, this is fuel tank configuration. And there is landing gear, main landing gear of the aircraft. Main landing gear. So this is known as the torsion link of the aircraft. Torsion link. This is known as the V. This is having the brakes over here. Nose landing gear doesn't have the brakes. It has the steering capability. Thank you.